This video shows you the installation and configuration of Active Directory and is only necessary if you create a development environment where you want to have your own Active Directory. The video is part of a series of 6 videos describing the installation process of SharePoint 2013. I'm going to install SharePoint 2013 in this environment where the left box, the first box, is used to run Active Directory and the second box is used to run SQL Server and SharePoint. Open Server Manager and click Manage to add roles and features. Skip the first dialog and choose a role-based or feature-based installation type. Choose a server where you want to deploy Active Directory domain services and select the Active Directory domain services role and add required features. Here you can skip the DNS server role since it's installed automatically. Skip the features dialog and click install to deploy the Active Directory role on this server. Don't close the dialog since there will be a link you can click to promote the server to a domain controller. After clicking this link, a new dialog will open and here you can choose to add a new forest and to enter a new root domain name. On the next dialog, choose the domain controller options. Here, for example, you can choose forest function level and domain function level. Keep the domain controller capabilities as shown on the screen and enter a restore mode password. Skip DNS delegation options on this screen and proceed to the next screen. Here you can keep the NetBIOS name given by the installer. Keep the path specified on this dialog and click Next to review your configuration options. Click Next to go to the prerequisites checker and after the checker has finished, click Install to configure Active Directory domain services on this server. After the installation has been done, you are prompted to log off and to restart the server. And after the server has been restarted, you can open Server Manager again and check for the newly installed roles. So what to do next? You can have a look at one of the other videos about software and hardware requirements, Active Directory, SQL Server, Windows Server or SharePoint 2013. Or you can go to my blog and have a look at updates, errata, scripts or tips and tricks.